What's up guys, this is Sohan and you are watching Technical Spark. In this video, I will show you that how you can add any computer to your domain. For this video demonstration, I am going to add Windows 10 client machine to my existing domain. So very first, let me show you that this is my domain controller server. You can see AD and DNS role is installed on this machine. If I am going to Tools, Active Directory, Users and Computers, then you will see right now there is none of the computer is part of this domain apart from my domain controller server itself. Let me show you that also. This PC properties. So this is my domain controller server. To add any system into the domain, very first what you will have to do is first check network properties of your domain control server. So let's go to the run and type ncpa.cpl and hit enter. So this is my Ethernet card, status, details. So my server IP address is 192.168.0.95. Subnet mask is 255.255.255.0. It's a class C IP address. And gateway is 0.1. And my DNS server is 192.168.0.95. Now we'll go to the client machine, which is Windows 10. In this machine, very first we'll check the network IP address. So in this machine also, go to the run and type ncpa.cpl. Go to the Ethernet, status, details, and check the IP address. So in my domain control, my IP was 192.168.0.95 and here I have 97, and my DNS server is 192.168.0.95. with the help of this DNS server, this client machine will communicate with domain controller. So let's check that whether it's communicating or not to the command prompt. Ping 192.168.0.95, enter. So it's able to ping my domain controller server. And if it's not able to ping, then what you can do, you can change the IP address by going to the properties, IPv4 properties, and here you can change the IP address of the client machine which you want to add into the domain. If in case you are using different subnet or different IP address, then make sure that particular IP range is able to communicate with your domain controller. Once this is done, close all these things and open the file explorer on the client machine. In file explorer, right click on this PC and go to the properties. In properties, as you can see, right now my system is in workgroup. So we'll have to click on change setting. In system properties, again click on change, select the domain and enter your domain name here and click on OK. It's asking for domain credential and enter the administrator credential, administrator password, and hit on OK. Welcome to the technicalspark.com domain. Great. You must restart your computer to apply these changes. Okay, close. System is restarted. Spark is my local user. But for now, since we already joined our system into the domain, so we are going to log in with our domain credential. So my domain is technicalspark/username administrator and password of that particular user, and hit on enter. My system is preparing for a very first time login, so it's loading all the user profile. Now it's loading all user profile and setting. Now let's go to the file explorer, right click, go to the properties, and here you can see that my system is added into the domain. Now let's verify the same on domain controller. Let's close all this. Now if I'm going to the computer, then here we should see our computer entry. So let's refresh Windows 10. So friends, this is how you can add Windows 10 computer into the domain. And same method you can use to join other Windows computers into the domain, irrespective of which operating system they are using, like Windows 7, 8, 8.1, 10, or any Windows server. Friends, that's it in this video. If you found this video useful, then please click on the like button and don't forget to share and subscribe. If in case you have any feedback, question or doubt, then please feel free to write in the comment box below. I'll definitely answer each of your comments. This is Sohan signing out. I'll catch you in the next video.